Hello Leo, welcome new viewers, cross watchers and my lovely, lovely Moonians. This is a monthly reading for January 2020 and I would just like to say Happy New Year. May this year bring you many beautiful blessings and realizations which empower you. All right, and this energy of slay kind of energy is coming in suddenly. Perhaps I've had too much coffee already. So anyways, so the first card coming through is Ace of Coins. The first one itself, it's like acing it. Oh, I'm getting very excited. This is talking about there is a lot of downloads which are happening, new ideas which will be coming in, new job opportunities which will be coming through. So opportunities for abundance, happiness, joy, fulfillment, rewards, going towards your goals will be coming through. So this is a really, really nice card for the first month for 2020. This is a very nice start. This is also a birthing period. So could be like, you know, after all the things that you have overcome, all the things you've learned and experienced, this is a time where you will be able to showcase your knowledge and your mastery and start something new, which is more in tune with you, whether it is financially, professionally, or even emotionally, or mentally, perhaps internally too, is what is coming through. Perhaps we can have certain kind of good habits infused into our life, doing something healthy also, going to the gym, hitting the road with walking or jogging, whatever you enjoy, that kind of energy is also coming through. But now is the time where you will start building your cornucopia, your happy life, that kind of a thing. Wow. All right. Finances, if there were certain kind of constraints or certain kind of worries which were related to finances, they will be put to rest is also what is coming through. New endeavors have a lot of promises is also what is coming through. Empress is a Capricorn energy, a little bit of Taurus, but that earth energy which is coming through, and we have a lot of earth influence which is coming in. New entrepreneurship is coming through very strongly. This is also a time where you start tapping into your altered state, and this is someone who is very nurturing, divine feminine, who is birthing with ideas, who is willing to explore new things, who has the power of healing others also, but she is first healing herself. She knows that she is a queen, and the inner queen, the divine feminine energy, is coming through very strongly. Luxury, success, abundance gets magnified with the Empress. So this is a very, very nice time indeed. Gifts will be coming in. Sudden windfalls also could be there. You never know. So, okay, that's way too many cards. So first, over here, we have Six of Wands coming in. So this is a very lovely energy of progression. Building up the strength, mustering up the strength to move forward. Letting go of the doubts, overcoming fear, and then moving forward with confidence, with the surety that you are here to achieve things, to achieve your dreams and make them into a waking reality. That is what is coming through. Forward movement is coming through. If things have been hostile or delayed, now is the time where there will be a new infusion coming through from the universe, externally and also internally. A lot of inspiration which will be coming through. So tap into it and utilize it. The other cards coming through is the Three of Coins coming in. So a lot of coin, pentacle energy which is coming through. This talks about that you have beautiful talents and now is the time that you put them to use. Put in the hard work, put in the legwork and see how your goals come true. That kind of a thing is coming in. Realizations, fruitions, harvestation, that kind of a thing. So put in the work. Be persistent and continue on your journey. You are tapping into a new direction in your life, which is more meaningful and in sync with you. And it's such a relief to have this kind of energy now, like, you know, irrespective of whatever the next cards may be. This is saying that just continue, believe in yourself. You have gifts, utilize them, utilize your skills is what is coming through. An hobby or a passion which can be made into something tangible too. So start thinking. bring that uniqueness into the world. All right. So we have the Knight of Coins coming in reverse. This is talking about a little bit of clarity before overly promising. That kind of a thing is coming through. So let's think and not really convey it, a little bit of discernment before you come out with the whole product kind of a thing is also coming through. A little bit of that is coming in. The other card is Two of Swords coming in reverse, which is talking about a little bit of confusion whether or not you should do it. Someone who has too many options and is kind of perplexed as to what to choose kind of a thing. So don't rush into it. Even if you feel that there is a strong pull towards pursuing something completely different from your current situation in terms of job as well, you needn't let go of that comfort zone at the moment, but start thinking of expanding those parameters is what is coming through. Let yourself have all the information before you make a decision. There's a need to step away from a situation and look at it from a different perspective to get the whole picture before you decide on something. Life-changing decisions are at play at the moment. We have the Hermit coming in reverse, which is talking about someone who may be retreating a little too much, who has been reclusive a little, and now is the time that you start stepping out. Also, with the Virgo Major Arcana coming through, this is talking about there is a need to follow your intuition. Know that there's a lot of insight within you. Even when you are making a decision, use your intuition also. It will be giving you the extra knowledge to make that decision. Red flags. There's a reason why your mind is cautioning you in a certain way. You know, acknowledge. That is what is coming through. Acknowledgement is very important. Lastly, we have the King of Swords coming in reverse. So these energies are talking about a little bit of confusion, a little more of clarity which is required, and not to make decisions on the basis of the information that you have currently, to have patience and then see what really comes through is also coming in. And apart from that, this is also saying that believe in yourself. You have the capability to achieve a lot. So there is a grounding energy with the earth signs which have come through. The air signs for communication is talking about you may be coming, or they, the other person may be coming from a place of confusion. So don't take things to heart or too personally during this time, because we also have on the 10th full moon in Cancer and also a lunar eclipse. So it could be like, you know, someone may be making you feel a little oppressive in a certain way, and you may want to protect yourself because vulnerability may be high, and this may come in as a lesson for you, or just a reminder that being your vulnerable self is also very, very powerful. Being confident in your authenticity, which also includes vulnerability, because with that you can be sensitive enough to induce what you're feeling, what you're going through, where is the anger coming from, if we are projecting any kind of inner pain with the reactions that we have. And in that understanding also, we let go of the judgment and embrace compassion and empathy. And with that change, we can address others and understand others also. That kind of a thing is coming through, because this is a very understanding person and they are very much drawn towards you for these qualities. They see you as an entrepreneur also. So they have this belief system that you can do anything. You can start anything at any point of your life and you will excel in it because of your determination and your intelligence too, talents as well. But these three cards coming in is talking about believe in yourself. All right. So that's a really lovely card with serendipity coming through. Allow things to happen naturally. Let them grow. Naturally is also what is coming in. Know that you are lucky. There's a lot of good fortune coming your way. The sun is shining and the cloudiness is going away. Going away. Sorry for the weird noises. My throat just suddenly went off. This is talking about clearly communicate. Or if you can't make up your mind, or you're feeling a little uncertain or unclear about something, don't jump into making conclusions. Don't jump into an argument prematurely is also what is coming through. Avoid that. Make sure that you are sustaining your sanity is also what is coming through. The other card is chop wood coming in. All right. Let me just check what this is. This is a very new deck for me. It has been there with me for a long time, but I haven't really explored it. So I'm just going to talk about the prosperity message which is coming in with this one. This almost reminds me of Cinderella. Just before she goes to the ball and everything changes. I think that is Cinderella with the snowshoes. Yeah, and crystal shoe kind of a thing. You're at the brink of something new that will be happening. Just like things are going to change. With the 18 coming in, there's a new chapter and a metamorphosis which is happening. With the 9, which talks about realization, reflection, realization, and then initiation, rebirthing, starting a new chapter. That kind of essence is coming in. Grounding yourself, feeling more secured in who you are, and then embracing and letting yourself shine in the world, that kind of a thing. So I'll just read this message first for you guys. Let me just see if this is getting reflected in any way. Yeah, that's good. So this says, now's the time to take small steps rather than larger leaps on the journey to creating your most prosperous life. Move your focus off your big dream and attend to the mundane course. Focus on the little things that may have piled up while you've been mapping out the greater plan for the life you aspire to see manifest into reality. This says, chop wood, carry water. As the Zen proverb advises, or wash dishes, walk the... I'm getting very zapped up. Or wash dishes... walk the dog. While you're doing all that, spirit will have a chance to move mountains and set wondrous miracles in motion for you. Remain humble and aware of the present. That is what is coming through over here. Take one step forward towards the gods and they will take 10 steps towards you. That kind of essence is coming in. One step at a time. Perhaps there has been a little bit of delay because we have been overbooking ourselves a little. This is talking about decluttering a little and becoming clearer of where you want to go. And then make rational decisions. With the King of Swords, I wanted to say this. This is someone who is, as a personality, very intellectual, very righteous, very disciplined, but in reverse it's like all haphazard and confused, being a little too biased, letting things slide and not being able to organize life. So planning things will be very nice as well, instead of jumping into conclusions or just focusing on the major milestones. Let's bring our focus more into the details, not getting caught up in it, but like, you know, just being in the present, enjoying the moment. That kind of a thing is coming in. Know that good things are coming your way. Help the universe help you. That kind of energy is coming through. Allow yourself to slay, mama. I don't know, it's a weird uplifting energy which is just getting charged up through this reading. Things are looking good. Just don't take too much stress. Allow things to grow. See how it flows. That kind of a thing is coming in. So what are the major arcanas which want to be known? Thank you. We have the Magician coming in reverse. This in this deck is talking about someone who is not really believing in their capability, or someone who requires to ground themselves because they have been in the air a little. So could be that this person or you perhaps have been caught up in things and you have been so worked up that perhaps someone is not being aware of what they're saying And it is causing a little bit of manipulation or to steer you in a certain way. That kind of energy is coming in. But all in all, this is talking about, understand that you have a lot of wisdom within you, a lot of power, again and again, the capability and talents to achieve and create anything, manifest anything in your life. That is what is coming through. Apart from that, we have the Fool card also coming in. So in a way, if you see, this is 1 and this is 0. A 10 energy of abundance, fulfillment, completions is coming through. So with that energy, again, focusing on the unfinished businesses, closing those chapters, and then focusing on what the next step will be is also what is coming in. All right, with the Fool card coming through over here, in terms of the new ideas, entrepreneurship that was coming through, this is telling you that believe in yourself and take the leap of faith. In order to experience new things in life or go towards a more meaningful life, a more abundant life, you have to take the first step is what is coming through. Trust yourself and have faith in the journey too. All right. So these are the cards which wanted to fall out. This reading is going very, very very, very quickly. All right. So the first card is support coming in. Ask for help. Get some rest. Get more rest. Nurture yourself coming in. Don't overwork yourself. Do what you feel is syncing up with you and enjoy it. Sometimes if you feel that you're not being, productive? For some reason, I couldn't think of it. Productive. Don't push yourself. Do something nice, cook, dance, do whatever, draw, or whatever is your hobby, whatever you enjoy. And remember that tomorrow is another day. Give yourself the time to breathe also, is something which is coming through. Take time to rest and rejuvenate and centralize your energy. All right. Beautiful cards. This says receive. Be open to receiving goodness. Believe you are worthy of abundance. A gift is coming to you soon. Wow. So rewards will be coming in. This is a time where you have been giving a lot, and now is the time that you open yourself to receive good energy, rewards, compliments, or whatever it is. Like, you know, the Empress is a confident person who is now receiving, whether it is inspiration, ideas, rewards, windfalls, abundance, for the efforts she's making, that kind of a thing. Be open to receiving, bring in balance in that way also. If you're the one who has been taking, who has been giving, whether it is in terms of understanding or energy, resources, now's the time that you let the other person give back to you is also what is coming through. And the other card is awareness. Live in the moment. Wow. Be conscious of your thoughts. Look for signs and guidance. So this is really nice. This is talking about living in the moment and embracing where you are, understanding there is already value in your life, and as you accept that, it will help you attract the same energy. So let go of the negative thinking. Choose optimistic thoughts. Optimism also is a major attraction factor in terms of love as well. As simple as start loving yourself, that kind of a thing for some people out there. Heal whatever is required. Take some me time is what I'm seeing over here. You have been doing a lot for others. Now is the time that you prioritize yourself. Know that good things are coming in because you deserve it. You deserve it. It's the energy which is coming through. Open up your world to receive the gifts and the galore coming your way. All right. So do let me know your thoughts. It's a very short reading, but it is a very apt one. Even in the last energy cards which came through, the unicorns are saying the same things. Believe in yourself. And make space for good things to enter your life. Think more positively for your own self. Embrace the change that may be coming in, which you feel so inclined to initiate in your life. Let's close the chapters, do the things which are on the wish list or the list that you've made for the day, and tick them off and feel that satisfaction of achieving each and everything on that list, that kind of a thing is coming in. All right? Let's make small goals which accumulate and go into the direction of your bigger goal. Let's diversify a little and not become stagnant or fixated on that one goal. Let's look at different things, experiment, have fun exploring different things which help you refine your goals, your capabilities, your talents, your skills more and enhance you so that you can go towards mastery also is what is coming through. All right? So do let me know if this resonated and please do subscribe if you haven't already. And thank you so much for being part of the Moonian family. Until next time, many, many beautiful blessings to you all and a happy, happy new year. Om Namah Shivaya. Keep that vibe high, my lovely Moonians.